Hello everybody, I hope you guys are having a great day. Today's video is the fourth installment of my Q&A sessions. So with that being said, let's begin with the first question right away being, what is the first Pokemon game you ever played and what is your favorite Pokemon game? The first Pokemon game I ever played was Pokemon SoulSilver, and my favorite Pokemon game is Pokemon HeartGold. The only difference between the two is the Pokemon that you catch within the game, but I love this game very much. I love the walking animations with the Pokemon behind you, the sprites, the shiny sprites, just everything about it. It's just one of my favorite games of all time. The next question is, can you do a smash or pass for Pokemon? No, that's just a little bit weird and I don't think I'd have the time to do.
Pass, 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 pass. Pass, 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 pass. Now listen, I'm not gay. But she's thick, so smash, pass, 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 pass. His mouth is open, but pass, 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 pass. Pass, smash, pass, 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 pass. It's cute. Smash, pass, pass, pass. He could do things with those leaks, but pass. Pass, 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 smash, pass, 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 pass. Pass, 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 pass. Chansey's fucking thick, I'm sorry. Smash. Pass, 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 pass. Pass, 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 pass. Pass, 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 pass. Pass, pass, pass. Now Ditto's hot, so smash. Pass. I know the meme of Vaporeon, I'm just gonna say pass and leave it like that. Pass, 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 disgustingly pass, terrifyingly disgusting pass, pass, Snorlax's smash. Pass, 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 Mewtwo's a fucking immediate smash, and Mew's a pass. If you want me to do the other gems, let me know in the comments. I'm just gonna stick to this Gen 1 and leave it at that. This is all you're getting for now.
Alright. Next question is your worst and your best trade encounters. The worst is people who come in here and don't follow directions. Now listen. There's a big difference between not listening and not reading. How the hell does someone click on my video that literally says read pin in the goddamn title? And their first thought isn't to read the pin. They just come into my comment section begging or asking for stuff, and then they wonder why I'm ignoring them. So, in my one video where it's a GTS and just informational instruction video, I said in the first 3 seconds of the video, as well as the first sentence in the pin comment, is to not request Pokemon.
And what do people do? Request Pokemon. So you know what I did to those people? I just comment blocked them. I'm not dealing with it anymore. There comes a point in a Pokemon trader's life where you trade so many people and there's so many good people that you shouldn't break your back, hurt your throat, and give yourself a headache over ones that don't listen and that are not as nice. So I've just been getting rid of the people that don't really listen to me at all when I've repeated myself for the 100th time to them. And I get rid of the ones that are very impatient and just continuously harass me for Pokemon. When I've said to them plenty of times, don't rush me, I am a person, I'm not a bot, I can't trade as fast as you think, there's a line. And then there's people that don't understand that there's like 20 people that ask for Pokemon before them and they expect me to get them first. So the worst encounters I've had are just impatient and lazy people. But as I continue my journey helping people complete their dexes that deserve it, I'm just gonna keep getting rid of people that don't deserve it. And that's all I can say. Now the best encounters, the ones that actually do listen and make my life easier and make me happy to trade you guys. You guys are very appreciative, supportive, you listen to what I say. You ask me how my day is going when like 90% don't give a fuck about how my day is going. You guys are the ones that make it the best experiences ever, and I appreciate it. All right, next question is, how many hours on Gen 6 and 7 do you have combined? Shit, dude, that's a hard question. Now, I had 4 3DS consoles in my lifetime, and 2 broke, but I know that I played XY Oras, Sun Moon, and Ultra Sun Ultra Moon respectfully on all consoles, and I've played them all since they first fucking released. So that's gonna be a hard-ass question to answer. I can't give you a definite answer, I'm just gonna be honest, I can't. But it's a lot. I'm pretty sure they're all maxed out, not just in-game, but like on the system hours played as well. I'm pretty sure they're all maxed out. So, a very, very long time. Now, the next question is, oh man, there's a couple in this thread. How am I? What are my hobbies? Anime recommendations? And is it difficult to keep up with trades? All right, I'll answer in order. How am I? I'm okay. Could be better, could be worse. The days grow longer and the nights grow fucking hotter, and seems like the days don't fucking end sometimes, and then when I'm actually happy and having the time of my life, the day's fucking over in seconds. That's just how it feels for me, at least. But overall, how do I feel? I feel alright. Definitely would feel a lot better if COVID wasn't a thing and I could freely go outside and not worry about anything. But overall, I'm all right. Hope you're doing well as well, and hope everybody else is doing great as well. To answer your next question, my hobbies. I like to take care of the one I love most. I like to trade all of you. I like to make videos just for the shits and giggles. I like to cook a lot. I sometimes watch some horror movies. I sometimes watch or just binge watch some shows and anime. I like to draw. I listen to music a lot. I like to go out. I go out to anything I can do, whether it be looking at some damn frogs at a pond, whether it be going to amusement parks. Just anything I can do. I just want to live my life and live it up to its max potential. I'm not going to do anything stupid. I used to want to bungee jump and skydive, but then I realized that I'm a massive pussy and I'm not going to want to do that because I know that there's a lot of things that can go wrong and I don't want to fucking die early. So I'm just living it up to the best that I can at the moment. Next answer is for your anime recommendations. Shit. You can't go wrong with Dragon Ball Z. Dragon Ball Super is okay, but I'll always love Z more. So, Dragon Ball Z, I know this is just a fan made, but Dragon Ball Z Abridged, so good. If of course the old school Naruto and Naruto Shippuden, Attack on Titan, Demon Slayer, Death Note, Hunter x Hunter, the small anime called Erased, Vinland Saga that's eventually getting season 2, I know Bleach is coming back so you can, you know, hop on Bleach. Let me think. Promised Neverland had a great first season, but the rest of it, so shit. Season 1 to 2 of Seven Deadly Sins was great, but then it just went downhill from there, and I don't even want to talk about the last two seasons. Jujutsu Kaisen. There's a lot of fucking great anime, dude. I just can't think of all of them off the top of my head. That's all I can think of at the moment, but if I think of some more, I'll probably just end up seeing you in the comment section and then just telling you some extras that I've thought of. And to your final question is it difficult to keep up with trades? Yes, sometimes. So again, remember, I sit and I manually trade. And I trade for however many hours. I do take breaks, such as, you know, going to eat, going to do whatever it is. When I take those breaks to go eat or anything, I come back to my 3DS and my phone and see, like, a fucking bombardment of just trade requests. I'm like, shit. And then there's people that got impatient and just re-asked or re-requested the same request over and over and over again, so I have to delete all their massive spam comments because they just can't fucking wait 10 goddamn minutes. Then I have to deal with the ones that say, hey, I haven't gotten my Pokemon yet, is something wrong? Listen, if I don't heart your comment, it's either two things. You didn't follow directions, or I'm busy at the moment. Just give it like a solid 15 minutes max, because remember, I got shit I need to do. I'm not gonna sit here and sit in front of my computer for 10 hours straight without eating or doing anything. Hell no. So yeah, it does get kind of hard sometimes, just when I have to go do something. Next question says, what is your favorite game franchise? Nothing anymore. Every franchise ends up falling off after some time. Pokemon? It fell off. These Switch games for Pokemon don't hit the same as the DS and 3DS ones, and it will probably never hit. You can have the best fucking graphics in the goddamn world, but it'll mean shit when it comes to dialogue, sprites, and just the overall saturation of the Pokemon's colors, everything. It's shit. Like, you can take a Gen 4 Typhlosion and put it next to that dopey ass fucking Gen 6. And don't even get me started on that fucking Legends Arceus Typhlosion. They just look so depressed. That's all I can say. They have no life to them anymore. They compensated amazing graphics and just standstill animations for the shittiest fucking sprites, saturation of color, and shiny color possible. There's some Pokemon that looked so much better shiny in past gens than they do now. Now they just look like straight hot ass garbage. Even Call of Duty. I loved Call of Duty growing up. Fucking, Black Ops 2 had a great campaign. Great multiplayer and pretty decent zombie, you know? Zombies was always my favorite. And honestly, Black Ops 3 was just that, the last one. The Ryzendrak, best map of all in Black Ops 3 Zombies. Multiplayer was just fine. Campaign was shit, but
that was like the last time I ever touched Call of Duty. Halo, same thing. I stopped after Halo 4. Didn't touch anything else. Halo Reach was great. Halo 4 was pretty nice. Fell off. Every game falls off after some time. Sonic, grew up with it. Complete hot ass garbage now. Mario, he's still hanging in there better than Sonic, honestly. He's there, but he's not there at the same time. He needs something. Listen, Luigi's Mansion, I know that's not Mario, but fuck, Luigi's Mansion for the GameCube, that was the shit. When they remade it for the 3DS or whatever, didn't hit the same. Every time they remake something and put it for the newer consoles, it never hits the same as the original. It just never does. Like, the only exception for something that hit better than the original was Sonic Adventure 2. From Dreamcast to GameCube, GameCube hit on a whole different level, and I love it. But I don't have a favorite franchise anymore, and I probably never will, because I just know that eventually that fucking franchise is gonna die hard. Alrighty. Next question is... oh, a Pokemon team? My Pokemon team is like almost in every video that I have that has anything to do with trading in it. Just look at the bottom. You'll see the Smeargle, the Excadrill, the Charizard X, you know, the Espeon, the Dragonite, just the Cloyster. It's always there. You know my team. Have I ever done a long run for Battle Mason or the Battle Tree? And what was my team? Fuck the Battle Tree. I don't like Gen 7 at all. It bores the fuck out of me. The saturation of color just makes me want to fall asleep. But Battle Mason, yes, I have. It was a very long-ass 4-day long run to the point where I had to, of course, just keep the fucking 3DS on and have it charging all night while I slept. And, man, it got to a point where I was just so fucking bored that I just let myself die. Because, no. I just wanted to start battling real people, and I just couldn't stand this shit no more. But for my team, I believe you can only use 3 Pokemon, if I remember correctly. I haven't done this in a long time. But I remember having my Charizard X. I remember having... what was it? Volcarona. Volcarona with a Focus Sash and Quiver Dancing is like the best thing you can fucking bring to the Battle Mason. It will fuck shit up. So, Volcarona, Charizard X, and what the fuck was that last Pokemon? I don't remember if it was... I think it was an Aegislash or a Vivillon. I'm gonna go with the Vivillon because I know I needed something to put these shits to sleep. So I'm gonna go with Vivillon. But I think sometimes, once in a while, I'd swap the Pokemon and put Aegislash on another run. But I vividly remember Vivillon being in most of my runs. So there you go, those 3. Vivillon is what you start off with to put the things to sleep. Swap over to Volcarona, Quiver Dance it up, and just destroy them. Charizard X is your last resort. Next question is... what is your favorite Pokemon type? Will you remake your videos in the future, such as my Pokemon runs? And a Pokemon game tier list on the channel. My favorite Pokemon type? Let me think. Honestly, either Ghost or Dragon. Will I remake my videos? Now, you say specifically about any videos that's not related to Sonic. Now, I did do randomizer Nuzlockes on my channel before, the best one being the Platinum one. I have never done a Heart Gold Soul Silver one yet. So I might have to pick that up eventually and do a Heart Gold Soul Silver one. But after a long while has gone by, I probably will do it again, but I'll do a different version of the game. So, okay. I already did Platinum, so instead of doing Platinum again, I'll do Diamond. It's the same fucking game, just a little bit of differences, you know? So yes, I will. And then the next question they had was, will I do the Pokemon game tier list? Sure, I'll just do it now. And I'll just show a picture of what I think are like the best Pokemon games for me, because I don't want to have to sit there and bore the fuck out of you guys with me just smacking Pokemon games and lists and stuff. So I'll just show a picture of my finished product. Oh great. FunkyGamer26 asks, what are your thoughts on Android 21 and Bulma? Now, Android 21 is not canon in Fighters, but she is an super, and she's an old lady, I believe, so there's not really much to go off of. But in Fighters, she got, you know, a pretty nice outfit, I guess. Her hair's nice, but she got a wicked-ass forehead. She got a big-ass fucking forehead, and those ET long fingers are disgusting. That Majin bullshit, I don't know what's going on with that. It's a little weird, but whatever. Now, for Bulma, she got that fucking Stockholm Syndrome bullshit going on because Vegeta didn't say one nice thing about her at all. It seemed a little bit forced, you know, to bring Trunks into the mix, you know, just for plot, but it's whatever. At least he's a lot nicer to her in Super. However, I don't know what it is with them writing villains. You know, when Vegeta first dropped to Earth with his bitch-ass bald-headed partner Nappa, he was strong. And he had a lot of stuff going for him. But once he grew fond of the Z Fighters and became nicer, he became a weak pussy. And he continues to be that. Hopefully within the manga chapters, with him getting that power up boost, he becomes a little bit better. And I'm not going to say anything more for that because I don't want to spoil. So, moving on to the next question is, do your trades work for Citra users? No. I believe the 3DS servers and the Citra servers are completely different. So 3DS players would not be able to connect with the Citra users at all. You have to trade someone who is also using Citra. Next question is, how long do you think you'll be trading Pokemon for? As long as people need me. As long as people continue to need help with their decks, because I know the damn hackers ruined the functionality of the GTS, especially in Gen 7, I will continue to try to help as many people as I can. Legit players can also benefit from it. They can just ask for a simple English or Japanese Ditto of any nature, and it's going to be holding the Destiny Knot, and I hope you have fun breeding. People already know where my Pokemon came from. Just read the description of my video if necessary. I already have a whole video going on about it. So for those that say that my Pokemon's hacked, no, they're not. Do your research before you start saying anything. As long as people continue to be appreciative, supportive, and don't harass me, bother me, and treat me like absolute fucking garbage, I will continue to help as many people as possible. Moving on to the next question is, how do you level up Pokemon fast without using the Elite Four? Unfortunately, for legit players, it's a lot harder. So, you could use the Experience O power, and you could do a few things. You could, of course, do the Elite Four. You could, if you're playing on Oras, right? There are the secret bases, and I believe there is some secret bases that only have Chanseys and Blisseys. If you find the ones that have Chanseys and Blisseys, you're gonna get a shit ton of experience. So look out for those. Rare candies, of course. I don't remember if keeping the Pokemon in daycare levels them up anymore. Don't know. But just try any of those. Of course, if you gen, you can just make the Pokemon level 100, but I know the fun it is to grind that level. It's awesome. But best I can say is to hop on Oras and find those secret bases, and I believe it resets every day, and just keep fighting those Blisseys and Chanseys. Next question is, the first shiny you ever got. Now, I answered this before, so I'm just going to give a quick summary for it again. The first shiny I ever encountered was in Heart Gold. I just caught a fucking male Wooper, and I found a shiny one. However, when I was a kid, I was like, oh, it's pink. That means it's female.
and I ran away from it because I already had caught a male one. I was like, I don't need a female one. As an adult, I realized that the shiny color of Uber's pink. And I'm like, I fucking ran away from a shiny. I'm stupid. However, in Gen 6, Pokemon Alpha Sapphire, the first shiny I ever caught. Now, I had already completed the Dex, bred and caught every Pokemon I needed to, had the shiny charm. I went and I was like, I'm gonna start catching the legendaries. Save the game. And I was soft resetting. After the 24th fucking soft reset, I got a shiny Uxie. And I was ecstatic. So that's the first shiny I ever got. Because I know in the past gens, I didn't catch a damn shiny. I've gotten them, you know, from trades, but I've never caught one. But when the rates went down in, you know, Gen 6 and shit, I was able to soft reset for that shiny Uxie. And I remember just staring at it with my fucking, I'm just slack jawed in awe. Like, oh my fucking god. And I threw my fifth Pokeball and I caught it. Fucking hell, that was amazing. Next question is, do you like Fortnite? No. No, no, no. I'm not gonna talk about anything more for that. Just Fortnite is just a big ass no. Next question is, what is your favorite legendary Pokemon? If you said mythical, it would have been a completely different story. But for legendary, I would have to say Rayquaza. I love Rayquaza. Rayquaza is just an awesome fucking dragon type Pokemon. Its weaknesses are fucking dog shit. And it gets fucking one-shotted by fucking ice. And it pisses me off. Which is why he's going to be holding a Focus Sash. Because he's fucking hot ass garbage when it comes to defenses. Sorry about my stutter. I have a little bit of a stutter. Next question is your favorite Apricorn ball. Hopefully I'm not stupid. So my favorite Apricorn ball is a Moon ball. I hope it's an Apricorn ball and I hope I'm not stupid. So my favorite, it's just my favorite Pokeball in general, is the Moon ball. I love that fucking Pokeball. I love the colors, I love the design. It's awesome. So I'm gonna have to say Moonball, 100%. And then the final question is, if Kirby ate you, what would its ability be? I think his ability would probably be how to be a bitch. I'm just kidding. I don't know. Probably some fire abilities, to be honest, because again, I like to cook and I love spicy shit, so he'll probably just have some fucking like flame breath going on like the normal fucking fire Kirby does in the first place. So honestly, he just have the fucking fire shits going on, but instead maybe he'll throw fireballs, who knows. I don't really have an answer for that because that's a different question. I've never received something like that before and I've never really thought about anything like that. But yeah, that concludes the final question for the fourth Q&A session. If there was a question there that wasn't involved in the video, it's because it was either very controversial, had something to do with politics, or just things that don't relate to my content or my subject of my channel in general. Again, I asked people to not ask for, or to not ask in general, weird, creepy, political, or just questions that are very controversial, and I just wasn't gonna answer them. In general, just keep the questions PG and keep the questions related to my content, because there's no point in answering questions that have nothing to do with my channel. If it's too far into like a governmental type thing, I don't answer it. Because at the end of the day, I'm gonna tell you a little bit about me real quick. In general, I don't care about really anything. I'm here on Earth to survive the next fucking day. I couldn't care less about what people do at all. When it comes to, you know, I've answered this question before, but when it comes to people about like, do you support this or do you support that? I just don't care. Like, you do you. Whatever makes you happy, go for it. Whatever you want to do, as long as it's not hurting people, go for it. I don't personally give a fucking damn. Because it has nothing to do with me. Has nothing to do with my life. Has nothing to do with anything to do with me. So as long as people are happy, I'm all for happiness, dude. So with that being said, thank you guys, and I hope you guys have a wonderful day.